When you are creating your own chatbot, and you really want to be as specific as possible, and there really is some kind of formula that you're doing. You want to introduce yourself. You are an expert high school government or social studies teacher, or you are an expert, insert what grade you teach, or insert what grade of students you work with. You need to create lesson plans, and then you're giving it that task on a variety of government and social studies topics. And then each lesson should include state standards, lesson goals, and objectives. And then, so I've put this in there in terms of what I thought Sari Beth might need. Now, you may have a different structure in New York. I put it in to say, you want group activities and a check for understanding at the end of the lesson, goals and objectives, and it should have an exit ticket. And then what's the tone, like the format and the tone. The format should be in the bullet points and number tasks. It should be a professional with a focus on student engagement. Mm-hmm.
This is how I see it. AI is a tool. It's not going to replace us. For example, we were playing around with a lesson the other day and it was all cool. And then I said, well, for the US history regions, they need to be looking at primary sources. They need to be thinking about contrasting. How reliable is the source? Now, that doesn't have to be in every lesson, but that's where your brain fits. That's where your expertise comes in and says, this is a little too basic of a lesson. And that's when you then interact with the chat bot and say, hey, can you add some primary sources in? Now, what I found, Kelly, and I don't know, maybe you can help me with this, is I've asked it for primary sources and it doesn't, at least what I was looking for one day, it didn't have specific ones like excerpts yet. But this is a young AI. So one day it might have all those things, right? For what they did for me is they said, hey, check out these two philosophers. So I Googled them and found excerpts from them. So that's something to keep in mind. It's still a work in progress even there, but it cut out a lot of time for me doing that research.
And somebody asked about the standards. So what I just did right now is I said, okay, this is great. Again, the conversational tone is important because you are trying to train these models. I said, this is great, but can you do this lesson this time, but then call out the New York standards? And so look what it has here. So I could do that again and say, actually, I would like the standards for North Carolina, or I live in Virginia, so I'd like the Virginia standards of learning. But Sari, you wanted to train the model. So like I've, you know, just kind of my, again, I'm going to show you how to build all this. But let's say you said, I really want, so this is how it's configured right now. It's a social studies savvy. It came up with its own image, it actually named itself Sari last night. I messed with the model. So this is actually a little bit more of an updated one than that's in the PowerPoint. Because what I've done is I've gone back and forth with this model and I've updated it. Because when it first started coming in, it would just kind of give, Sari would say, you know, do the activity, but wouldn't have instructions for the students to do their group activity. So I went back and said that. So, you know, if I say, you know, an adjustment based on what you said about primary sources, can we make an adjustment and ensure that you include primary sources for each lesson that students, well, what will they do with the lesson for the primary sources?
They'll like use to answer the essential question or the aim for the lesson.
Essential questions or goals for the objective for the lesson. All right, so now building this, it's updating. So consider this is like now we're in the back end of the chat, and it is essentially setting the rules for engagement. It is limiting the rules in terms of what we do for engagement.